Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning and the old cookbook show. I've got a big pot of beef and barley soup on the go. So for today's recipe, we're going to do something out of this. Rumford Southern Recipes. Rumford Baking Powder. It's now part of Clabber Girl as all of the baking powder companies sort of get consolidated. This was a cookbook sent in by one of our viewers. Thank you very much. Rumford is a baking powder company based in Providence, Rhode Island. And as far as I know, Rhode Island isn't part of the South, but the cookbook is called Southern Recipes. It's undated, but given what's inside, I would say probably 1900 to 1925, somewhere in there. It is what most collectors would call ephemera. Cheap paper-based recipe books that were given out for free as promotional or marketing pieces that were meant to be used up and discarded. This was not meant to be in my hands 100 years later, but it is a great little cookbook. And indicative of the time, it's got a hole in the corner and a little piece of string. You were meant to hang it on a nail in your kitchen so that it was always there, always available, so that you could go back to your favorite recipes. I love this kind of thing. The recipes in a lot of ways are almost inconsequential. They are corporate recipes. Really, they're corporate recipes. They're meant to sell you baking powder. And the recipe we're going to do today is called Rumford Sweet Potato Biscuits. And it uses 6 tablespoons of baking powder. So we're going to start out with flour. Now, the cookbook doesn't specify what kind of flour, but earlier in the book, it does talk about the different types of flours that are available on the market, and that soft winter wheat flour, which is mostly used in the South, is best for biscuits. I didn't have any cake and pastry flour, which would be the closest that I can get here in Canada, although I could probably get one of the American brands if I really searched through all of the grocery stores here, or if I wanted to send Jeff Bezos to space again. So into the flour, I put salt. And I'm going to add some sugar and the baking powder. And I'll just get in there with my hand and mix that up, bring it together a little bit. Next in, it asks for shortening, and today I'm using lard. And we'll just bring that together with our fingers. And so I mix this with my hands until I can't see any pieces of lard at all. So the flour is completely coated with the shortening. The whole idea of shortening is that you're coating the flour with it and it'll keep the strands of gluten from forming, shortening them, so they don't form long strands. I know we've gone through that quite a few times over the last little while, but it seems to be something that a lot of people comment about in the comment section, that they didn't know why shortening was called shortening. So lard is a kind of shortening. And I'm sure that in this time period, Crisco probably would have been the number one shortening on everyone's shelf. People would have been moving, in the cities at least, towards using a vegetable shortening. Okay, that looks really good. I think I've got everything coated. So now I've got a cup of cooked mashed sweet potato. And there's absolutely nothing added to this sweet potato. I just boiled it up, skinned it, mashed it with the fork right in the cup. And this is one small sweet potato. Worked out quite nicely. So, doesn't say how to mix that in, does it? Nope. Add the potatoes, then the milk gradually, and mix to a soft dough. So, my hands are already in there. Let's go. The recipe asks for about a cup of milk, and I imagine that about a cup of milk is depending on how wet your potato was. If the potato had a lot of moisture, you probably won't need as much milk. It also says you could use water. So water is definitely acceptable in this recipe, and you could use a mixture of maybe water and milk if you wanted to. I'm going to use all milk, and I think I'm probably going to use most, if not all, of the cup. Okay, let's see. Get back in there with my hands. Bring that together. Okay, that's come together in a nice ball of dough. I'll put some flour out on my surface and put this out. Clean my hands, and then we'll roll it out. Get the rolling pin, and we'll roll this out to, it says, a half inch thick. That's going to be a lot of biscuits. Okay, I think that's about a half inch. It might even be a little bit thinner. So I've got a baking tray, and I've got a piece of parchment paper on it. You probably don't need the parchment paper, and I've got a little biscuit cutter, although we've got a collection of biscuit cutters inside that belong to our grandmothers, and they were sardine cans and or tuna cans that were just repurposed. No need to buy a fancy cutter when you've already got a can in the house that will do the job. So I'll just cut these out. It says to bake them in a hot oven, so I've got the oven at 375. Could even be a little hotter, maybe as high as 425, but we'll see how this works out. Sweet potato certainly gives it a really nice color. So I think I can get one more here, and I can get one more onto the tray. And the rest of this dough I will re-roll and get a couple more into the oven.
Nice job, Glen. Hi, friends. Glen apparently is enjoying his soup.
This is some really good soup. That is some really good soup.
Is it time for biscuits, though?
It is time for biscuits now. Okay, so we can have the biscuits now. These are sweet potato biscuits from the Rumford Southern Recipes cookbook.
Like they're a very soft biscuit. Like I usually don't think of biscuits as being something you can squoosh.
Mmm. That's a very nice texture.
Mm-hmm. It's really soft.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so the potatoes, a sweet potato itself doesn't add any flavor.
No, I was surprised. When you said it was sweet, I was expecting a little more sugary flavor to it, because sweet potatoes are lovely that way.
Adds color and an amazing texture.
Mm-hmm.
Like sometimes I find biscuits to be...
That's just what I'm saying. It's like, look at that.
It's
like fluffy.
It's fluffy.
Very dense.
Yeah.
But I do love a dense biscuit.
That is a great biscuit. That is a great biscuit. I think that is a biscuit that I could get behind.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, a little sweet potato in your biscuit recipe. Thumbs up from us. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.